Hello boys and girls, welcome to Benchart. I'm Obscurangel PT and we are currently here benchmarking Star Wars Battlefront on the single player with my HD 7850 and my beautiful desktop. So I'm running this on the Ultra Preset, I'm going to show you later. I'm running it on Ultra Preset and I did benchmark Ultra, High and Medium Preset, which you can check the details of the video or just skip to the end of the video to enjoy a beautiful graphic showing all the frame rate that I was getting and other stuff too. But to start off, let me just show you the settings, alright? And let me inform you that MS Afterburner isn't working on my desktop for this game and I'm not sure why. I'm not sure why this is happening, because it worked pretty well on my laptop, but on my desktop it's not working. I searched a lot on Google and many things and I didn't find any answer for this. Many people have this problem but they didn't seem to fix it. It's weird. So with that I decided to record this with Pedicam, which is awesome. But with that I'm going to let you enjoy the gameplay and see you soon. Goodbye.
Control.
Thank you. missiles coming within range. Imperial sharpshooters near you. Soon forget that. Drop pod on the way.
We've identified the position of another escape pod. Move on it as soon as possible.
Imperials, come here to scanning range. New AT-ST detected. Thank you.
So welcome back now to the performance section of this video, and as you can see on Ultra we get an average of 43, on High we get an average of 54, I mean, and on Median we get an average of 76. So the question is how the PlayStation 4 keeps up in this game. The PlayStation 4 can get almost always the 60 FPS, which we can't get in here. But what's the settings that Sony is using in this game? The Sony is using 900p with the eye settings and with the shadows between low and median that we don't have to choose from, but if we choose median we are currently having better shadows than PlayStation 4. So yes, PlayStation 4 ran this game at the eye settings and with the shadows very close to the median of PC with 900p. So if you want to enjoy the similar experience to the PlayStation 4 and have almost always the 60 FPS experience, you need to put everything on high and shadows on median and drop the resolution scale to 85%. Because resolution scale is a much better option to drop the resolution than dropping the resolution. And you're gonna see why if you try out. But the fact is, we are not running the game at 1080p and this sucks. So for me, if you want to enjoy 1080p with some drops or some things like that between 50 and 60, you can have it with the eye preset with no problems at all. It's just smooth. You can overclock the graphic card or many things like that. But if you truly want a 60 FPS experience and above and beyond, you either choose the median preset or you either go for the PlayStation 4 settings and lower the resolution to 900p. I mean, drop down the resolution scale to 85%. So about other things like this is that this game doesn't consume too much VRAM. At least for me, I'm just seeing 1.3 to 1.6 gigabytes of VRAM usage. RAM usage, I didn't even saw the 4 gigabytes of usage in this game, which is very nice for many people that didn't upgrade it yet for 6 gigabytes or 8 gigabytes. CPU usage, it was not the problem, and the GPU usage, my graphic card was always on the limit to render this game. So next benchmark will be Star Wars multiplayer. Let's see how different this game will run on bigger maps and with 40 players. Thank you a lot for watching, guys and girls. See you soon.